here's something fun. I was out exploring in my extremely underpowered miner, and I ran into some pirates, and they've been on my tail for the last 20 kilometers, launching missiles, and I've been trying to hug the ground and go as fast as I can without going into orbit, which I almost did, because I was going a little too fast. Anything over 150, you're pretty much guaranteed to hit orbit. Now, I'm coming up on my home base, because I basically am making a run for home. This thing can go up against a ship, but going up against all those missiles and stuff at the same time? Yeah, I don't think so. So I'm basically making a run for home and hoping that if those missiles catch up, which they're almost on the other side of the rock now, that if they do catch up with me, they're going to get a whooping. Although I do have the truck and the mothership a few hundred yards apart, I'll just fly in between them, and there should be enough firepower between the two to take care of these guys. I can't go exploring until I have more, until I clear those guys out. I got a beep or a blip on the other side of the planet that I went to check out, and that's where I was heading when these bad guys came along and to ruin my day. Now this ship has a combination of ion thrusters and hydrogen, and I've been burning the hydrogen a lot. I actually mined a bunch of iron, and I had to use the hydrogen just to get out of the hole. I added a whole bunch more engines too. I think it's got like 16 ion thrusters. And that's just to keep up on this surface. Because this is a combination of gravity and no atmosphere, so it's the first time I've actually flown a ship in that condition. The low gravity makes it really difficult to do anything in an ion-powered ship, because they're just not that powerful. So the addition of the hydrogen has really made it possible. Between these two, I should have a fighting chance, right? I think they're confused because I was going so fast across the ground that the curvature of the moon, you know, just like how I told you how piss poor the autopilot is, it can't figure out how to compensate for the curvature of a body. I mean, their autopilot's having the same problem. They're trying to draw a straight line between them and me. And according to, you know, what they think, this is just a big asteroid, and they're just waiting for me to come out. I'm sure that's what the autopilot has it said. It's like, okay, well, get as close as you can and then wait. And actually, it looks like the ship's despawned. We got a couple cruise missiles, but the ships themselves are gone. And I have my radar on maximum. I don't see them showing up now. Oh, there goes a cruise missile. It looks like I outrun them. That's pretty cool. Yeah, there they go. And here I almost wasn't going to record this. I said, you know what, I'm not going to waste my time trying to record this, because it's just going to be a boring exploration trip around the moon. So now I have to start over again, because I don't remember where I was. I just ran into these guys out of nowhere, and they started firing missiles at me. And I was like, okay, I'm just getting the hell out of here. I do know that I found a signal about 16 kilometers away, so I'm gonna plan on checking that out. See, look how slow this is with just the ion thrusters. It's literally pathetic. And then I just kick on the hydrogens, and then we start the boogie a bit, you know. I should have enough hydrogen to scurry around a bit some more. I think I'm probably down to about 50%. I loaded up completely when I left. Okay, let me get myself back onto auto thrust. Auto thrust is the best. You just override and then you just sit back and steer. Don't have to hold your fingers, hold the keys down forever. What is nice with the addition of all the extra thrusters I put on this thing, I can fly it now without hydrogen at all. It's just really slow. I can't haul anything either. If I pick up some more, because this is a miner, if I pick up some more, pretty much anything over the weight I am now, I need to add, you know, I need to kick the hydrogen in. So I drew basically a straight line between the booster and, you know, I forgot to put, dang it, I forgot the GPS coordinate again. I'm not going to turn around. I basically drew a straight line between the miner and the booster, and that's the direction I'm picking. Because I guess that would be, I don't know if the sun's rising or setting. It's been up, it was really dark, so it's probably rising, so that's the east. I'm probably heading north. It's going to be my guess. So that's east, that's north. So we'll just take a general north direction. You know, and I'm really excited because, and I guess I could show this to you while I'm flying. Did a little bit of bitching on the forums, on the Space Engineers forums, about how they broke the exit in the cockpit, forcing a third person every time you exit the cockpit. Check it out. They fixed it. That's why they want to jump out. But yeah, they put a hot fix in last night. They didn't even tell anybody. I just decided to play a little bit today, and I got so used to hitting FV. It was just like a habit now. It was like FV, FV, FV. Every time I get out of the cockpit, FV, FV. I was doing that. I'm like, what the hell? I keep getting thrown in the third person view still. And then I tried it without doing V, just hitting F like it used to be, you know, like it was forever, for years, because they broke it 2 weeks ago, and they, I guess because me and a couple of guys bitched about it, they hot-fixed it last night. They just slipped it right in after the big update, because they did the weekly update, and I tested, you know, 5 minutes after release, I had it installed, and I already figured out that they didn't fix that, and I went right on the forum, and I said, you know, guys, you know, it would be nice if you would have fixed that thing that you broke a couple weeks ago. It's really friggin' annoying. And a couple other guys, you know, agreed, and they fixed it. So there we go. Now, if they would just fix the way you aim at blocks when you grind on them, that would be awesome. Because it used to be perfect. I don't know why they screwed it up. They did this inverse kinematics crap. You know, because they want, you know, people complain about spider's legs going through rocks, and when you're walking around, you have these you know, it doesn't look right because you're walking through solid objects. And so, you know, to me, I don't really care that much about that stuff. I want the gameplay to work. You know, I want things like, you know, real bugs to be fixed, stuff like the rotors exploding and, you know, piston heads. And they said they fixed the piston heads. I haven't lost one since, so maybe they really did fix the piston heads. I don't know. I just realized I'm going really slow. Let's see if I can crank it up a little. It's like when I'm driving and I start bullshitting while I'm driving. I start driving really slow and get behind somebody slow, and then I'm usually passing everybody. And then you start bullshitting and you miss your exit. It's like, yep. It's like I'm bullshitting and flying in space. Oh, here we go. Some more hunter killers just spawned. Well, this time I'm going to go straight. If I have to go all the way around, I'm not going to let them chase me off my course. Still got the sun to my right. I'm just going to hold course and let them come. And if I have to, I'll kick off my dampeners and I'll swing sideways and unload my Gatling guns. I'm going to let them chase me this time. Especially now that I know that I can just outrun them. That's something else they need to fix. That's stuttering. Now they did include an option to turn off oxygen pressurization, which is supposed to fix some of the laggy issues. But I just spent that time pressurizing my station, so I mean I can turn it off and see if that little laggy stuff goes away. I think it's really related to the pirates spawning, because I would get this lag too when the spiders would spawn. I think it's just they just have it so that it requires too many CPU cycles. Like, they don't have it running on a separate thread for response. That's really lazy programming. This is a good engine. I mean, I do have a monster computer, so, you know, for me it runs fine. Lots of people are complaining about how poor the performance is, but I mean, for me, I'm getting 62 frames a second right now, so that's not too bad. The really thing is, it's just the micro stutters that really annoy me, especially when it comes at a bad time. Ah, there we go. I got my tiny unknown object showing up again. Yeah, see those? That's what I was chasing after. So I gotta watch this altitude. If I get over 500 meters, there is a chance I could just pop in the orbit, and then I have to fight that again. These craters are deep. Let's have a lot of computer problems today. Stupid Adobe products not working right. So I spent pretty much the whole day trying to get them working. Never did. I think it's going to come down to doing a Windows repair. I think I have some funky DLLs. So I really didn't record or play today. It's the weekend now, so I'll probably put a little more time in. I tell you what, they certainly try to come after you. And it's nice to know that the spawning is working, because I was having an issue for a while. I didn't think the pirates were spawning at all. Like, I didn't see any for, like, days, right? And then all of a sudden they started spawning again, and I'm like, okay, maybe it had something to do with the update they did. It seems to be working now. Although I don't know if my custom script that I downloaded for making it, I think it's called Hostile Universe, it seems to sometimes work and sometimes not. I don't think the default pirates in the game launch missiles. I think that has to be a script thing, although I don't know. So you got these tiny ships coming up. Interesting, it looks like they seem to be too close to be... See, my ship is 19 kilometers away, but those tiny ships are 6 kilometers away, and they don't... Oh, there's another unknown object. It makes me wonder if they're in the center of the moon. I'll try aiming towards this... Pops back up. Watch the altitude. That's right, my speed's going up. see how easily it is. I'm just going into orbit. Okay, there's something over here at 3 kilometers. That's definitely on the surface. What is that that's 1.59 away? That has to be in the Earth? Like 500 meters down. That's crazy. Now I'm really curious. What the hell could be down that deep? Yeah, you know these guys are gonna come after me now. Okay. So it's just something that's crashed in this crevice. It's not actually, like, buried in the planet somewhere. At least I don't think. It's still kind of weird. I think I'm going to be in trouble here. Not showing up on my radar, which means I must be close. Funky. Alright, now these guys are coming in. I don't have much of a choice. I'm gonna have to shoot them down. Give me my zoom. Hope I don't need a save game after this. That's weird. I know what's going on. They're going so fast that by the time they turn around to come get me, those are some cool explosions. I don't remember them looking that cool before. Maybe they did a little enhancement. There's gonna be a lot of debris here. Hopefully not mine. Oh boy. Oh boy. These guys are they're just relentless. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do this. I have lots of ammo, but I wish I had a turret. Wee! I see more coming in. It's kind of weird that I'm not banging them up at this range here. Explode! Am I just not aiming or something? Ooh. I can't keep track of them all. You know what's shooting at me. I don't think I'm going to survive this one, guys. Well, something just happened. Oh, I hit the ground. Shit. That's usually not a good thing. Whoa! Alright. That was enough. Okay, I'm going to take the better part of valor and run. I just can't take these guys out. There's just too many of them. If I can climb. Oh, ouch. Okay, let's try that again. Realize this thing is just not a fighter craft. It does not maneuver very well. It's like everything I got to make it over this stupid little bump. Now I'm going too high. Just doesn't have enough balls. Okay, which way is home? That's the problem. Another problem is I'm going too dang fast. So much stuff spawning right now, it's just killing the lag here. Okay, I think I'm going in the right direction. I see pivot stop 18 kilometers away. I'm just gonna have to boogie. Shut the hydrogen off now because it's certainly getting chewed up. Yeah, I'm down to half ice. But I'm fine now. I'm doing a good clip and they're not going to catch me. Look at all those missiles. That doesn't even include the ones I shot down before I died. It only put me back about 2 minutes from death. So I'll just head home, and I think what I'm gonna do, because that's the second time I tried to explore and got got walloped by these guys. I think I'm going to either refit that fighter ship I have in the hangar, the one I looted like ages ago, and then armored the front. I'm either going to refit that, depending on how it handles. I'm going to guess it'll probably barely lift off in this environment. So I think I'm probably going to do is just grind that thing down, get rid of it, use those resources to build a new ship from scratch that is designed for an environment like this, which is low gravity, no atmosphere. So I have a combination of large ion thrusters and small hydrogen boosters. And it won't have like a large cargo storage or anything like that, but it will, you know, I'll put a bunch of cannons on it. Maybe I'll put a rocket turret on the roof instead of a regular turret, because that would be pretty damn effective. Having a rocket turret on your roof would certainly do a number against these guys. So maybe I'll do that. Maybe I won't do it tonight, but I'll put that on my agenda. I think that's a good plan. Because I can always use that in space, too. It doesn't have to be a low-gravity environment. Something like that would maneuver excellent in space. It'd be an excellent, you know, fighter craft for space. And that, you know, that one that I looted was found in space. I mean, it works fine in space. It just, I don't think it's really going to handle this environment, because it requires a lot of downward thrust, and that's something it doesn't have. It has six of these small ion engines, which I have six on this one. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I have two in the front, which you can't really see. I have six pointing down on this one, and this is a pretty light craft, and it barely stays afloat. So yeah, I already know that what I have in a hangar isn't going to cut it. So I think I'll chop that and build a new craft. That's like my favorite thing to do anyway. And maybe I'll try doing it with like darker armor blocks. Make it like a black ship. Pretty cool. I usually just use the standard camo, but maybe I'll make I'll like call it like Predator or something. Pretty cool. And as I suspected, you know, I totally lost those guys. They're gonna despawn. I bet you that tiny unknown object up there is a bad guy. It's just outside of my scanning range. Yeah, I want to find out what that stuff is that the tiny ships. And I think there's probably a base. There's got to be a pirate base somewhere. I was probably getting close to it. So anyway, now that I'm safe, this is all pretty boring stuff. So, till next time. Welcome back. It's a new day, and I am taking the truck back to the ship. Tell you what, it's been a heck of a lot of fun driving this thing on the moon, just because of the low gravity, and it's so heavy, and it's like driving a whale. That's the only... it's like a giant boat. And I noticed when I turned the gyros off, I can actually steer the thing. And you notice I have two of the jets on full blast to kind of give me a little artificial gravity. Keeps the ship from flying off into space, which, even as heavy as this is, I get it up enough speed and I hit one of these big bumps, you bet your bottom I'll launch. And I did it once and smashed the whole front of the truck. Had to reload the game. Just too much stuff to fix. You know, if I break something minor, it's not a big deal, but you know, when I lose the whole front end, it's too much work to put it back together. It's just easier to restore. So I thought you might be interested in watching the docking procedure. I'm done with the truck because I got enough iron for now. I did drive around a little bit while it was daytime and found some iron. Got some processed. I'm probably going to need more eventually, but it was a big shipload, so. Now, the tough thing is getting up this ramp without smashing the gun off the front, because that's what I did last time. And I can't really go up it at an angle because I don't have enough ramp space to do that, so I kind of have to go straight on. See how it kind of, the front just rubs on the ramp there. I gotta wiggle it back and forth to go up. So I'm just gonna go ahead and kick on the hydrogen engines to get that boost. There we go. And the wheels are on. Should be okay at this point. Or not. And there we go. The whole ramp exploded underneath the truck. Dang it. Okay, let's try that again. This time I turned off the gravity engines. I don't know if maybe that extra force caused the problem or not, but we'll find out. I mean, I've used this ramp twice before and it has not collapsed. On both sides. Let's hope I don't bump the jets. Thrusters on the other side. Oh, I saw it buckle for a moment. Looks like I am gonna bump. Boy, it's hard to turn on this thing. I saw the ramp buckle. Now, did it break off of the rotor or not? I don't know. I won't know until I inspect it. If it broke, I'll just fix it. Still not too fond of that system, but it's the best thing that I have right now to get this thing up and down. I was thinking about a piston platform, like actually lowering the whole truck down into on this platform, but that'd probably be a pretty big undertaking to get that to work right. Certainly get rid of the ramp idea, but then what happens if I'm on uneven ground of some kind that I wouldn't be able to lower the platform, so. Okay. The truck is locked, so I'll go ahead and shut off all the engines here, lock the parking brake, doesn't do anything, just double check and make sure all the engines are off, they're not, and this is a couple of ion engines there that did not shut off. I think that was just because I had a, I shut them off manually because I didn't want them to counteract natural gravity. I wanted as much downforce as possible. Okay, so that's locked. Oh, that's so nice not to go into third person anymore. I did put this, put these extra blocks under the ramp to provide a little bit of support. I know weight and mass doesn't really count. Like, you can put a billion tons on this ramp and it shouldn't collapse. Like, there's no structural, like, rigidity of steel in this game. That's why they need to fill them out. But, I guess we'll find out if the thing goes up or not, if that rotor's been busted. Because it did bang and shake really loud, and that's usually a sign that something broke. Jiggling. Looks like it's still in one piece, though. It's good. Alright. And that just shuts the motors off so that it doesn't vibrate around. I haven't had it fall yet with the motors off. I was going to use the rotor lock. But that's kind of experimental. I never did unlock the solar panels. I figure I really don't need them right now. I think the jump jets and everything have been recharged by now. That was something else I wanted to do. I forgot. I wanted to add a couple more batteries to the system so I didn't get the overload issues. So I think that might be something I do next. Still really good on ice. I only used 0.3 million. For that whole trip, and all the ice I stole since being here for navigating my ships around. I filled up the miner twice off of that. And I'm going to check the ice on this too, because I did steal some from here, and I also did use the hydrogen engines several times. Let's see how we're doing here. Okay, we're a little less than half. That's okay. That's plenty. I just installed a new mod. In fact, I installed two new mods. I might try them out now. Let me see if I can get the locks to show up. Don't know if it's going to work in dev or not. I don't know what is it called, a vaporizer? Yeah. It's supposed to create ice out of air. Now, of course, it's not going to work here because there's no air. It looks like it's only for a large ship. Yeah. So I'd only be able to put it on the large, on the booster mothership anyway. So let me see how big it is. So it's like the size of a refinery, basically, or an assembler. Okay, well, I'm probably going to want to add one of those just so that the ice will stay topped off anytime in an atmosphere. Not supposed to make a lot, but it'll be enough over a long period of time that I might not have to go running around digging up ice. Can I even fit it just like right here? Technically, I could. Or I can put it here. Oh, you know what? It's going to need a conveyor. So I'll need to figure out. And then there is a conveyor system behind this, feeding that turret. So I'll have to figure that out. So I think I'm going to add a couple batteries. Maybe I'll add that vaporizer thing. I was considering setting up a cruise missile platform here on near these welders, using the welders to, in a blueprint hologram to start being able to launch cruise missiles. And I also need to build that fighter craft so that I can do some exploring. So I'm gonna be pretty busy creating stuff. I'm not gonna really record it. I'll just show you bits and pieces as I am doing it.